For those of you watching this show for the first time, just know you've started in the right season. Yes, election period. Chaos in all camps. So Tunu versus Akena, Besigye versus Muntu, and most especially, Sevo versus Amama, who is currently trying to wear a yellower t-shirt than anyone else in the party. Just like the ripest mango, which is symbolic of him falling off the tree very soon. But that is for another day. Today we are doing the special Ask Omara edition, where you ask the questions and we try to answer them to the best of our knowledge. Or not. So, fire your questions away. It's business unusual. Here is what you'd like to know today. Hi, my name is Yusuf Kajimu, and I'm a boda-boda rider by day and a chef by night. I also own a restaurant where I sell things, but I lack training in the first profession, boda riding. So Mbu, I hear they are giving training to boda cyclists in Kampala. Also me, I want. Where, when, and how? Well, Yusuf, according to today's new vision, it turns out there is actually boda cyclist training going on within Kampala City. Yes, people are being trained on highway codes, how not to kill people, especially yourself and your passenger, and also generally how to respect pedestrians, because half the time you take their path. Yeah, it's going on, and all this is working towards you getting a learner's permit as a boda cyclist, which is good, yay! I personally am more concerned for the drivers, but those are the guys you should be worried about. I mean, when boarders have accidents, they kill the rider, maybe a passenger. You never hear of a boarder hit a car and the driver of that vehicle died. Because in Uganda, the rule is the bigger the car, the more likely you have right of way. Now, those are the guys who need training. Presidential convoy, MPs, SUVs, and truck drivers. Those people need training. Yusuf, you go get yours, and let's hope also other people will get theirs eventually. The shilling is losing, I hear. Yesterday, I left my wallet in a Pioneer bus, so I also lost the shilling. My question is, can you lend me some dime? Well, it's not like I work in the dollar department or a forex bureau. And you see, the thing about life is, there's a reason why you lost that money, particularly the shilling. Yes, it's symbolic. You don't hear white people complaining, oh, I misplaced my dollar wallet in Kampala. I mean, it doesn't happen. So that's a sign that you should not have had that money on you, particularly those shillings. What I would suggest is whatever money you have left, go and swap for dollars so that you don't lose the shilling again, just like the shilling is losing now. And most importantly, I can't lend you money because that would be me interfering with God's plan for you. There's a lesson you're meant to learn from that event. Number one, don't board buses. Buy a car. You get the point. So even if you lost your wallet in your vehicle, you'd probably still find it there, unless you took it to the car wash. On that note, sorry, Bambi. Why is government preventing Amama Mbabazi from looking for votes, and yet they turn a blind eye when other people's supporters demonstrate? People who already got many votes, like Eddie Kenzo. I've explained this before, but now I'm going to have to explain it again, in yellow. Fine. The thing is, Amama Mbabazi belongs to a party that has been around for 30 years, and it turns out they're used to the concept of sole candidate, and right now is violating the principles for which the party stands, and they are not happy about that. So they said, no, you cannot stand. And they said, ooh, me, I want. And then here we have this whole hullabaloo, and his lawyers have currently met the police, and the US has threatened to withdraw funding if they do not let him stand. In brief, what I'm trying to say is, I think to them, Amama is a threat, unlike Kenzo, who is a Gulela Alice. Yeah, that's great artist, by the way, in Kenzo's American English. So yeah, which one of the two would be more intimidating? The educated lawyer who has been in politics for over 30, 40 years plus? Or this other guy? Exactly, my point. Besides, Kenzo didn't even have a party color. Unless it's red eyes after drinking. But that's it from us at Business Unusual. Thank you all for your questions. We really do appreciate it. Again, congratulations to Eddie Kenzo. I personally have no beef with you. Unless it's what you're eating for lunch, we will share. Yeah, thank you all for joining us. Tomorrow we continue with the chaos of what we call Ugandan politics. Yes, the Kavuyo is ripe and rife. Otunu versus Akena coming up shortly. On the next episode, that is. Bye for now. See you all.